present with you, even as you utter this word, the cross of God. Quench our faith, God. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The fifth word of Jesus on the cross. John 19:28. Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." Some misunderstood the word of Jesus and gave different interpretation to it, and those who were wicked then, they took advantage of the craving of Jesus and decided to abuse his grace. Was Jesus actually thirsty for water? He ate the Last Supper and he said, "Until I eat this in my kingdom with you, I'm not going to take this again in the world." They brought vinegar. The gall, bitter things, they put it in his mouth because they wanted to use the opportunity to abuse him. If you read the place, they have two dogs there. He said, later, knowing that all was now completed, because the scripture, his ministry, all his job on earth had been completed. That is one thought. Look at the hand there, the conjunction, bringing the other thought. So that the scripture, and so that the scripture will be fulfilled. The scripture in Psalm 69:21, that they put gall in my food and gave me vinegar for my thirst. They gave me vinegar for my thirst. Jesus left heaven for about 33 and a half years. He was in the world. He was longing for his place of glory. He was waiting to see the fulfillment of the redemption of man. He was waiting to see the hour when God will open his mouth to say, "Those I say they are not my children, I will call my children. And those I say they are not loved, I have called my beloved." He was waiting for God to give the authority that will back up his name, so that at the mention of the name of Jesus, according to Philippians, every knee will bow. He was waiting for the moment he will see man qualified to sit and dine with him. He was waiting, he was thirsty for the moment he will see man shackles of the devil. He was waiting for the redemption. He was thirsty for the redemption of man. He was the second Adam. He came to bring life. He said, "I am thirsty." Just imagine Jesus crucified, surrounded by his enemies. Who would give him water? Even if Mary would have brought water to Jesus, would the Jews allow Mary to give Jesus the water? Jesus knew that he had less than a few minutes to live in this world. If you read Isaiah 53:11, he said, "After the suffering of his soul, he shall see the light of life and be satisfied." He was destined for this satisfaction. He was thirsty for the glorifying of God, not for the glory of this world. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What is your thirst? What are you thirsty for? Is it money? Jesus would have had the opportunity of showing himself. The greatest expectation the Jews in the time of Jesus have ever had from Jesus was on the cross. That was when they were telling him, if you say you are the Christ, bring yourself down. And we will be convinced, not even by the miracles you have done, but by bringing yourself down. Jesus looked at all those things. He said, no, this is not what I'm thirsty for. I'm thirsty for the glory that comes from God, not for the praise of men. I am thirsty for seeing the moment the ministry I have come into this world to fulfill will be done. And God will tell me, well done, my son, with whom I am well pleased. What are you thirsty for? Is it wealth? If you thirst for the things of this world, the Bible says, Jesus said, the wealth of this world, moths and robbers will come and spoil it. If you are thirsty for wealth, if you read Ecclesiastes chapter 5, he says, those who love money will never be satisfied with their income. And those who love wealth will never have enough.
Is it for clothes? Things of this world, good. You have BlackBerry, said the BlackBerry is not enough. There is iPhone, you go for it. iPad, you go for it. The only thing that can satisfy you is in Isaiah 55. Let's read that scripture before we pray. Isaiah 55, verse 1. Come, all you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you who have no money, come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk, without money and without cost. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Praise the Lord. This, for those things, that will give you eternal benefits. Don't taste after power, because power intoxicates.
there is marital power. Either the woman using her instrument against the man or the man against the woman. Any form of power intoxicates. The only thing that can give you satisfaction is Jesus. Heaven. Build your home so that you will not live in a thatched house in heaven. Praise the Lord. Right, so can let us pray. Father Lord, our King, songwriter said, in my heart, Lord, lift it up. Come and quench the thirst of my soul. Breath of heaven, fill me till I want no more. So we say, fill your children today. Fill them. Quench every thirst. And we divert the attention of our thirst from the things of this world to the imperishable things that will never, that no criminal can rob from us. This we ask from you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.